Hello, I'm Juicebox. Welcome to my tutorial about building and installing LMMS from source code. I'm running on Ubuntu 16.04, but this process should work on almost any relatively recent Ubuntu release. So first of all, we need to remove any existing LMMS and Wine installations. Then, we need to install Wine 1.8, which is a more recent version and will make VST plugins more stable, using a PPA, which stands for Personal Package Archive. Then, we're going to install the LMMS build dependencies, which are packages that are required to build LMMS from source. Then we're going to download and extract the source code, and then we're going to build and install LMMS. Before we get started, it's good to back up the LMMS folder. Usually, this isn't necessary, but in case something goes wrong or if your system is different than mine, you might lose that folder, and with it all of your projects and samples and music and stuff. So just copy that and paste it somewhere safe like the desktop. Open up a terminal and run sudo apt-get remove lmms wine wine dev. Hit enter, type in your password, and it will ask you if you want to remove the packages. Press Y and hit enter. Now do sudo apt-get auto-remove. This will remove any leftover junk from the previous command. Now we're going to install Wine 1.8. I'll put a link to this website in the description, and I have it bookmarked so we can get to it really fast. Scroll down to the instructions and do sudo add apt repository ppa ubuntu wine slash ppa. This PPA is managed by Scott Ritchie and Martin Lankhorst. Thank you. Now do sudo apt-get update and then sudo apt-get install wine 1.8 and wine 1.8 dev. You don't need to install wine tricks like listed on the command on the left because that is a GUI interface that allows you to install Windows programs on Ubuntu. But that's not necessary because the only reason we're installing Wine is so we can use VST plugins, which don't need the separate program. Now we also want to do this command here. Sudo dpkg add architecture i386. I don't believe that this is necessary for building, but it will eliminate a lot of potential errors and overall just make the process smoother. So we finished installing Wine 1.8, and now we are going to go to the LMMS GitHub page at github.com/LMMS. Click LMMS. And this would be a good point to download the source code because the button's right there, so download that. Save file, and then go to wiki, and that link near the middle, compiling LMMS. This is a handy instruction manual for us, including a list of build dependencies and this command that will manually install all of them. So just copy that whole command and paste it into your terminal. So it's going to give us this error because it's not sure which version of Wine Dev it should install, 1.8 or 1.6. We just installed Wine Dev 1.8, so we don't need to install either version. So press the up arrow to go back to that command and go to the place where it says Wine Dev and just erase it. Enter. Yes. We are on a 64-bit system and it's almost certain that you are too. So this command will install the multi-arch libraries for the compiler, which fixes compilation terminated, wine gcc g++ failed, which is very annoying. Ubuntu isn't considered an other Debian-based system, so you don't need to run that command. We're not on a Debian i386 system, so we don't need to run that. So we already fetched the sources, but we do need to extract them. So go into your downloads folder, right-click that, and click extract here. You can go in there and look around. All the source code is in there, and if you're, like, good at code, you can maybe, like, modify some stuff, but that's up to you. Go back to the terminal once you're done and type in cd for change directory downloads. Then cd lmms master. And then ls makedir build. Now we're going to do change directory into build. And then cmake dot dot. Dot dot means target this command on the directory outside this one. This will basically just check to make sure everything's set up properly for compiling LMMS. And also it will generate some like files and stuff. If there are like a few errors up there and like a few things not found, that's probably okay. That happens every time I've done it. But as long as you get those three messages at the bottom, configuring done, generating done, and build files have been written to blah blah blah, you're good. Now do make dash j and the number of CPU cores you have. If you're not sure how many CPU cores you have, you can go into a new terminal and type in ls CPU. Now go up until you see an entry called number of CPUs, or just CPUs, or if you have one socket, which you probably do, CPUs per socket, and that's the number right there. So just put that number in. I'm running on a 2-core processor. And now we're building LMMS. This may take a long time, or it might not. It really depends on how good your computer is. For me, it took about like 8 minutes. And congratulations, you've successfully built LMMS from source code. If you didn't get to this place, tell me in the comments, and if there was an error, post that too. I'll try to help you. If you did get here, do dot slash LMMS and prepare to be amazed. So as you can see, they have an awesome new theme. If you want to check any of these boxes, you can. And then for the sound device, if you're not sure, just try those devices one by one. Just do the first one, restart LMMS, do the second one, restart, and so and so. And whichever one works best is probably the right one. Okay, that window will appear. Okay. And voila! Custom built. Pre-release LMMS. So click triple oscillator a few times just to make sure everything works as far as sound. And then you can close LMMS. And now we're going to actually install LMMS. So it's going to appear in your menu, it's going to be saved on your hard drive, all that stuff. So do sudo make install. And then you can close all of those windows. Now open up a browser and go to synth1.com. This is a VST that works very well on all platforms, and it's good to test to make sure Vestige is working properly. Vestige can be kind of unstable, especially on custom-built LMMS versions, so just test it. So go to your downloads folder, right-click that one, extract here, and then you can look inside, but you want to take the whole folder, cut it, go into the LMMS folder and put it in plugins, VST. Put it right there. Yep, my projects are still there, so didn't overwrite them when we compiled it. And now you can go into your menu. LMS should be in it. And go ahead and launch it. Put in a new vestige track. Click it. And open up Synth 1. Since this is the first time we've run Wine on this computer, it's going to pop up this window saying we need to configure Wine, or that it needs to configure it, or whatever. It may have you install several Mono and Gecko packages to give you compatibility with the VST plugin. Just go along with it and click install. Make sure you don't click LMMS during this process because it is very unstable. And then just reload the VST plugin, and there you go. Hit some keys to make sure everything's working. And that's pretty much it. Just use LMMS normally and check out all the cool new features. Thanks for watching this. I hope it helped you. And have a good day. Bye.